Let's look at this question. In a theater, there are five different types of seats: A, B, C, D, and E. The price per seat of all the seats of particular type is the same. However, price per seat is different for different types of seats. Okay, so price per seat is different, but for a particular type, all the seats are priced identically. Okay, the first pie chart below provides the percentage breakup of the total number of seats in the theater by the type of seat. So this gives you percentage breakup of total number of seats. This is for number of seats. Okay. The second pie chart provides a similar breakup of the revenue that the theater could have earned for one show if all the seats in the theater were sold. Okay. So this is for revenue. Wonderful. And then there are two pie charts, and then there are questions. Now, when you look at the questions, all these questions start up with the word if, which means nothing precise can be identified. There are going to be cases. Let's try and make sense of the data here. When you look at the percentage breakup of seats, A is 20%, which is nothing but 1 by 5. B is 5%, which is nothing but 1 by 20. C is 1 by 4. D is 3 by 20. And E is 7 by 20. Looking at the denominators everywhere, can you come to the conclusion total number of seats will necessarily be a multiple of 20? So I'm operating with the minimum possible case where A, B, C, D, and E, there are exactly 20 seats in the theater, and then A will have precisely 4 seats, B will have precisely 1 seat, C will have 5 seats, D will have 3 seats, and E will have 7 seats. This is the minimum possible case when there are only 20 seats. This is a split of seats when there are only 20 seats. Okay. Now, if there are 20 seats, I'm also working with, let the total revenue also be 20 only. Total revenue be 20 only. And therefore, now you can find out the price per seat very quickly. So 24% of 20 divided by 20% of 20 is as good as 24 by 20, 24 by 20 is nothing but 1.2, 12 by 5 is nothing but 2.4, 20 by 25 is nothing but 0.8, 30 by 15 is 2, and 14 by 35 is 0.4. So this is price per seat that we have identified when revenue is also equal to 20, seats are 20, revenue is 20. This is the count of seats. This is the price per seat. Okay. Let's get to the individual questions. If on a particular day, the revenue from each type of seat was the same and all the seats of one particular type were sold out, which of the following type of seat was sold out? Okay. One of these particular types has been sold out. So the revenue generated if A was sold out completely would be 4.8. Revenue generated when B was sold out completely would be 2.4. For C, it would be 4. For D, it would be 6. And for E, it would be 2.8. Hopefully, you can clearly come to the conclusion that if the total 100% of the seats were sold out for one particular type, it has to be B. Because if it was for C, then 4 revenue would be generated, and there is no way you can generate a revenue of 4 for B. The maximum revenue generated, in B is 2.4, and that is the revenue generated in all five types for all five of them to have exactly the same revenue. Therefore, the answer to question number one will be option A, B. This is the working that we have done for question one. Okay, now let's go to question two. If on a particular day, the revenue from each type of seat was the same, and the price of the seat of type C is rupees 80. If on a particular day, the revenue from each type of seat was the same and the price of seat of type C is 80, what is the minimum number of seats sold on that day? Okay. If price per seat of type C was 80, effectively price per seat, everything, price per seat, each of these would get multiplied by 100 and you would end up getting 120 and 240 and 80 and 240. These would become the prices per seat. Now for prices per seat, For B, the revenue generated, because there is just one seat in our storyline, the revenue generated would be 240 and there would be one seat sold and revenue. So 240 here, so you need 240 here also, revenue is identical, so you need two seats here, 240 here, you need three seats here. For 240 revenue here, you would need 1.2 seats here. And for 240 revenue here, you would need 6 seats here. So the seat sold that you are going to get is going to be 2, 1, 3, 1.2 and 6. Sadly, there is also this condition that the number of seats sold should be an integer. You cannot sell 1.2 seats somewhere. In order to turn this 1.2 seats into an integer, each of these terms need to get multiplied by 5. So actual number of seats sold, actual seats sold would have to be these individual numbers multiplied by 5. So you get 2 into 5 10, 1 into 5 5, 3 into 5 15, 1.2 into 5 6, and 6 into 5 30. How I'm reaching multiplied by 5? 1.2 in fractional terms, 1.2 in fractional terms is 1 by 5 or 6 by 5. If you want to turn this into an integer, you need to multiply it by a multiple of 5. The smallest multiple of 5 is 5 itself. Therefore, the total number of seats would be 10 plus 5 plus 15 plus 6 plus 30. You add all these ups and you get 66 as your total, which should be answer to question number 2. Again, all this processing was for question 2. Let's get to question 3 now. Question 3. If on a particular day, at least 60% of the seats of each type were filled and the revenue from n types of seats were the same, what is the maximum possible value of n? Okay. So if 60% is the min, if 60% of the seats are filled, or if 100% of the seats are filled, this is the minimum case. Min is the 60% case. Max is the 100% case. For max, I don't need to bother. I can copy the number from question 1. So I get 4.8, 2.4, 4, 6 and 2.8. For 60%, I simply need to find out 3/5 of these numbers. So 3/5 of 4.88 is going to be 2.88. You simply half and add 10%. Half is 1.2, 10% is 0.24. So you get 1.44, half is 2. And 10% is 0.4, so you get 2.4, half is 3, 10% is 0.6, so 3.6, half is 1.4, and 10% is 0.28, so you get 1.68, so 60% to 100%. Now you have to identify what is the revenue generated in A is something in this range, for B something in this range, for C something in this range, for D something in this range, and for E something in this range. Within this range, hopefully you can see, for 2.4 revenue, you can have B, C and E. For revenue of 2.4, you can have B, C and E. And in the range 3.6 to 4.24, 3.6 to 4, you can have A, you can have C and you can have D. These are the maximum this is the maximum possible value of n, where the revenue is identical if minimum 60% of seats are occupied everywhere. In either case, you will see that there can only be three portions or three types of seats. Therefore, for question number 3, answer has to be option C, 3. Let's look at the last question, question number 4. Again, this is the processing for question number 3. For question number 4, what they're saying is, if on a particular day, at least P% of the seats of each type were filled and revenue from the four types of seats was the same, what is the maximum possible value of P? Again, there will be min type something and max type 100 only, 100%. For 100%, the numbers would be identical, 4.8, 2.4, 4, 6 and 2.8. Now see, hopefully you can identify, given that four types are identical, four different types, revenue from four different types of seats are identical, either you would have to exclude B or D, because B has the lowest revenue and D has the highest revenue. If you exclude B, you see that D and E can never have the same revenue. D and E can never have the same type of revenue. Or if they have to have the same type of revenue, 6 would have to go down till 2.8. 6 going down till 2.8 would mean 2.8 divided by 6. Sorry, the reduction would be of 2.8 divided by 6 into 100, or you get 7 by 15 into 100, or you get what? 7 by 15 is nothing but 46.33%. So the value of, if D is being excluded, you would need min of 46.33. You would need min of 46.33. Okay. If D was being excluded, you would want A, B, C, and E. Let's look at A, B, C, and E. Out of these four, A is the maximum one. A is the maximum one that needs to be reduced to at least 2.4. A is the maximum one that needs to be reduced to at least 2.4. So 4.8 to 2.4, you will need to have min as 50%. Between the two of them, the higher maximum possible value of P should be 50%. In order to make it clearer, let's work with 50%. Revenue for A would turn out to be 2.4. For B, it would be 1.2. For C, it would be 2. For D, it would be 3. And for E, it would be 1.4. So at revenue precisely 2.4, can you see you can have A, B, C, and E. Four of them can be identical. Therefore, minimum 50% case is more preferable for us. So the maximum possible value of P will be nothing but 50, and that is the entirety of your question. What this requires you to deal with is identifying the numbers here, knowing that these are ratio numbers, then some degree of number manipulation. If you're comfortable with that, this should be a fairly simple question.